The After Effects team is on a roll, pushing the 3D envelope further and making our lives easier, or at least more fun. In this video, I'll take you through some of the latest 3D tools recently added to the beta. So buckle up, we are starting. Things are moving at warp speed, so if you want to follow along, make sure you have the latest After Effects beta. You can grab it from the Creative Cloud app. I'm using version 25.2, but I have a sneaky feeling there's more cool stuff on the horizon. If you're not already one of my frequent flyers, hit that subscribe button and give this video a like. Yes, even before watching, I promise it's going to be worthwhile. All right, let's dive in. The first thing is FBX 3D model support. To show this off, I've got this comp with a few 3D layers sitting on this Ali clip. Big thanks to Bonus Studio and of course all the talented artists from sketchfab.com. Links are down below. Now notice this dancing rabbit layer. Yep, it is an FBX file. In case FBX doesn't ring a bell, it's one of the most widely used formats for 3D models. And now you can drop them directly into After Effects, complete with animations, cameras, and lights. This is fantastic because tons of stock sites support FBX, and if you work with Cinema 4D or Blender, this makes life so much easier. Oh, and Mixamo fans, good news! You can bring in animated characters like this rabbit and have them bust out some Gangnam Style. And speaking of animation control, let's move to the second thing, which is 3D model options in the properties panel. So this one makes adjusting 3D models way easier. Now you can quickly tweak how a 3D model responds to light and shadows and select, of course, embedded animations without digging through menus. Let me show you how. I'll select the Mixamo channel for this rabbit and preview the comp. Right now I'm using Draft 3D so we can get things moving in real time. Now we also get compositing options for all supported 3D models, and animation options are available for GLB, GLTF and of course FBX layers. This is a small but mighty feature, though personally I'd love to see this available for solids, text and shape layers too, so we could tweak shadow colors more efficiently. Right now, if I want to adjust the shadow color on the floor, I'll have to hunt it down in the timeline. Now this is not a deal breaker, but hey, let's dream big. The next one is a big one, animated environment lights. You can now use any composition, video or image layer as an environment light, not just HDR or EXR files. Now here is a pro tip. If you use an existing layer, duplicate it, otherwise After Effects will switch off its visibility. This new feature makes everything feel more connected because your scene lighting now reacts realistically to the video layer itself. And for extra realism, you can bump up the shadow resolution before rendering. Trust me, you'll want to avoid flickering, so set it to full or double if your gear supports it. Also, if your 3D models have reflective materials, you can start seeing real reflections like on the roof of this car. I just wish we could tweak model materials inside After Effects the same way to show some reflections when we need them. Maybe someday, who knows? Now some quick notes on what doesn't work. You can't use 3D objects, lights, cameras, 3D nulls or 3D layers as an environment light source. It must be a 2D layer. And also, some effects like the checkerboard effect doesn't play nice in reflections unless you add a solid composite effect or a solid background underneath them. So transparency is a little bit broken right now. And now the next three things are some helper commands for common 3D workflows. Adobe just made some tedious 3D workflows one click easy. Let's check out those helper commands. The first one is applying effects to 3D layers. If you ever wanted to add some 2D effect onto a 3D model, now you can do it easily. All you need to do is select a 3D model. In this case, I'll select, let's say, this robot layer, and then go to Layer, Create, create 3D layer instance, and a solid layer is created at the top of your composition level with the CC composite effect apply, which is already referencing your 3D layer. Now the original model gets turned off, but if you want to keep the shadows, just turn it back on. Now this is great for quick color fixes or maybe just blurring those overlay crisp edges of those 3D models. And yes, you can also right click on your 3D layer to access this command, which is just a wonderful time saver. The second thing is look through a light. This one is really cool. Ever wished you could control a light like a camera? Well, now you can. I'll create a spotlight and I'll select it, and then I'll go to layer, light, control light with camera. This will create a link camera, which will let me aim my light with the same precision as a 3D camera. So just use the camera tools. You can tap 1, 2, 3, or hold down the Option or Alt and use a 3-button mouse. Now here's a pro tip. If you adjust the cone angle of a spotlight, it will automatically affect the linked camera zoom, which is so smooth. If you want to switch back to your main view, just disable this camera layer in the timeline. And if you want to multitask, use a two-up view in the composition panel, which will allow you to position the light while you are seeing the effect in real time, which is my preferred way of working. Now, one heads up, this only works with spot and parallel lights. Also, deleting the linked camera will cause some expression errors. So if you don't need it visible, just turn it off or put it underneath all the layers instead of just deleting it. You can always use the camera pop-up menu to switch between different cameras. And now for the last feature, which will create a 3D environment layer background. So this command helps you to see your environment light. And to activate it, you'll need an environment light in the scene. And then you can go to the layer, light, create environment layer background. Once selected, After Effects will generate a solid at the bottom of the comp with the CC environment effect applied plus a little fast box blur to soften it up. This makes it easy to troubleshoot your 360 degree lighting. Now, if you want a seamless texture, you can click on the card on screen or check the description, because I've got a cool recipe, a quick tip to help you with that. So in this case, I'll cut corners literally and quickly apply my preset. And of course, you're welcome to pause the video and copy my magic values. And this, of course, will make those seams disappear and create a seamless texture. Now note that this only works when using a custom source layer as the environment light, not the default source that comes with After Effects. I suppose it would be nice to have this as a right-click command too, but hey, I'm just nitpicking here. So, what do you think? Let me know in the comments, and more importantly, share your feedback with Adobe via the beta forums or the feedback bubble in the app. Personally, I'm thrilled that Adobe is doubling down on 3D inside After Effects. The more we can do without leaving AE, the better. And if you made it this far, here is some inside news. This is probably the last tutorial I'll record in this setup. We are moving to a new house next week, so hopefully I'll be back soon with an upgraded office and even more fun content. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again soon.